Let's revise the meaning of displacement reaction. A more reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal from its salt solution. This is called displacement reaction. First activity, displacement reaction between copper sulfate solution and zinc. What is the procedure? Take a 50 ml of water in a beaker. Dissolve a spoonful of copper sulfate in it. Copper sulfate solution, which is blue in color, is obtained. Add zinc granules in the beaker, as you can see in the diagram. What do we observe? Blue color solution of the copper sulfate disappears and a red powdery mass settles at the bottom of the beaker. What conclusion do we draw out of this? Zinc is more reactive than copper. Zinc replaces copper from the copper sulfate solution. This copper gets settled at the bottom of the beaker, which is red colored powdery mass, and zinc sulfate solution becomes colorless, as you can see in these diagrams. Now let's study the chemical reaction. Copper sulfate plus zinc gives zinc sulfate plus copper. Let's study the second displacement reaction. This reaction takes place between copper sulfate and iron. The procedure is, take 50 ml of water in a beaker. Dissolve a spoon of copper sulfate in it. Copper sulfate solution, which is blue in color, is obtained. Add iron nails in the beaker. What is the observation? A red powdery mass settles at the bottom of the beaker. What do we conclude out of this? Iron is more reactive than copper. Iron replaces copper from the copper sulfate solution. This copper, which is red powdery mass, settles at the bottom of the beaker on the iron nails. Do you see? In the first in the beaker, you can see blue color copper sulfate and iron nails. Now iron has replaced the copper from the copper sulfate solution, and the solution have turned green in color, which is iron sulfate, and red color powdery mass you can see on the nails, which is nothing but copper. Let's see the chemical reaction. Copper sulfate plus iron gives iron sulfate plus copper.